Hallowed be your name, Father. Your name is glorious. Your name is powerful. Your name is excellent. Your name is beautiful for situation. Your name, O Lord, reacheth out unto the clouds and is above everything. And at your name, every knee shall bow. We worship you for that wonderful name. Hallelujah to you, Lord. We ask, Lord, that as we continue on this, our series on the prayer life of the disciple, especially this seventh edition, we ask, Lord, that you will teach us by your Spirit. Teach us how to pray, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. This is our seventh edition on the prayer life of the disciple. In Luke chapter 11, verse 1, the disciples came to Jesus Christ and asked and requested that he should teach them how to pray, even as John the Baptist taught his disciples. And in Matthew chapter 6, beginning from verse 9, Jesus began to give them a guide. Jesus began to reveal a pattern unto them. Jesus wasn't asking them to recite the prayers that he inserted there, but that it should be a guide in terms of how they should pray. Amen. Praise God. Now, in the previous three series, we have been able to look at, you know, the early part of these prayers where Jesus said unto them, he said, when you pray, say, our Father who art in heaven. Amen. Today, we're going to be looking at hallowed be thy name. And I just want to read three versions, you know, of that scripture to be able to explain further in depth, you know, what Jesus meant by hallowed be thy name. Now, the King James translation of Matthew chapter 6, verse 9 says, hallowed be thy name. Amen. Now, the Bible in basic English translation says, and also the Word English Bible translates as, may your name be kept holy. Amen. Now, the Dabis translation says, let thy name be sanctified. Amen. So, the focus here is on, you know, the name of the Lord. Praise God. And what the scripture, basically, what Jesus is asking them to do in terms of hallowed be the name is that they should consecrate the name of the Lord. They should worship the name of the Lord. They should adore the name of the Lord. They should treasure the name of the Lord. Amen. Praise God. And it is important to indicate that there is really no difference between God and his name. God is his name. You cannot say that you treasure God. You cannot say that you value God and not value his name. No, it's basically, it's basically impossible. Any honor that you give to God, you are automatically giving, you know, unto his name. But if you say you love God and you do not love his name, or you love God and you take his name in vain, obviously you do not really love God. Amen. So the honor that you give to God is the same honor that you are giving, you know, unto his name. Amen. And to drag God's name to the mud, you know, is simply to drag himself, you know, to the mud. There cannot be any difference. You cannot differentiate between God and his name. God is known by his name, just as you are known, you know, by your name. Amen. Praise God. Now, when Jesus said, hallowed be thy name, what he's simply saying is that God's name is to be sanctified. And the word sanctified means, you know, to set apart. And when you set something apart in the Bible, basically it is set apart, you know, it is set apart as holy. And anything that is set apart or that is sanctified is not to be used carelessly, you know, or unadvisedly. Amen. You know, Moses and Aaron in the Bible were denied the privilege of taking the children of Israel, you know, into the land of Canaan because they did not sanctify God before the people. Numbers chapter 20, verse 12 says, and the Lord spake unto Moses and Aaron, because ye believe me not to sanctify me in the eyes of the children of Israel, therefore ye shall not bring this congregation into the land which I have given them. They didn't sanctify the name of the Lord as far as the Lord is concerned. And so God said, both of you, you are not going to enter into the promised land simply because you didn't sanctify me before the people. So to hallow the name of the Lord, it simply means to sanctify the name of the Lord. It means to set the name of the Lord apart as holy and not to use his name carelessly, you know, or unadvisedly. Amen. Praise God. Now, to be effective in prayers as a disciple, you cannot dishonor the name of the Lord. If you dishonor the name of the Lord or dishonor God himself or use his name in vain, then your prayers cannot be effective. Especially as I've demonstrated earlier, that the honor you give to God is the same honor you give to his name. They cannot be different. If you dishonor the name of the Lord, you are basically dishonoring God, and therefore your prayers, you know, cannot be answered. And if you look at the Old Testament carefully, you know, God's law, one of the laws of the Ten Commandments, states explicitly that you must not use the name of the Lord in vain. And this is amongst the first the amongst the first three commandments that relates directly, you know, even to God himself. Look at Exodus chapter 20, verse 7. It says, thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. So if you do not hallow the name of the Lord, you do not sanctify the name of the Lord, you do not reverence the name of the Lord, you do not venerate the name of the Lord, there is no way in which God is going to answer your prayers, because then you will be taking his name in vain, and he says he's not going to hold you guiltless. And if you are not guiltless, you know, before the Lord, then obviously your prayers cannot be answered. Amen. Therefore, to hallow the name of the Lord is to sanctify the name, his name in your heart and on your lips. It is to venerate God's name and to dread it. It is to place a high value, a high premium in the name of the Lord. And it is not to use his name in vain. In fact, as far as the Bible is concerned, it's a heinous crime, you know, to use the name of the Lord in vain. So Jesus says, as you approach God the Father, when you say, our Father who art in heaven, hallow his name, worship his name, exalt his name, treat his name with reverence, and then your prayers will be effective in the sense that God will answer your prayers. Father, we ask in the name of Jesus, Lord, that in our daily prayer lives, O God, you will help us, Lord, to reverence your name. You will help us to worship your name. You will help us, Lord, to adore your name. In our daily activities, in our hearts, and even in our words, Lord, help us, Lord, to sanctify your name, not to use your name in vain. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Glory to God.